What's up, guys? Today is Friday. Finally, Friday. Because today's the best day of the week. Because of this reason right here. There's the man himself. So let's see what he's got. Come on. Feels good in here. That white box looks good.
Yeah.
You must have had a trade-in on it.
No, it was a repo.
Uh-oh.
Trade-ins always go better, but I mean, wasn't no drama with that one. The guy just ain't showed up in a long time.
I like it, box. A nice one. It nearly matched my stuff.
Yeah. It ain't bad shape.
Somebody was wanting a part number on them screwdrivers. The master set, so there they are. A big set of screwdriver. Yeah, that's a good looking car. How bad salty is it?
I think he owed $720 on it. Looks like a $1,200 car.
Yeah. Man, I'd hate to know I almost paid half of it.
Paid half of it off and then decided to quit paying on like a $35 a week payment.
Yeah, if I was gonna let my box go, I'd want to do it like when I owe early. Like all of it.
Yeah, yeah, early in the deal.
Like
yeah.
You unload it this week, next week, be like, man, I don't know about all that.
Yeah, don't wait 2 years on it and then.
Oh, well. Yeah, they still, some people talking about you repoing my box and all that. I'm like, good Lord, really, guys? Come on, man.
I had text messages, people asking me like, so, why'd you have to repo Clay's box? I was like, I didn't repo Clay's box. I mean, we sold that box. I just don't believe that. I was like, well, you can believe what you want to, dude.
Yeah.
I mean, that one.
It wasn't no secret. Like, the day we put the top box on it, when I walked around it, was the first thing I said.
The first thing was the gap.
I said, I don't like the gap.
Yeah.
And it ain't nothing, and I tried to tell everybody, it ain't nothing to do with Hamilton. Like, he tried. He called. Yeah, I know for a fact
I talked to the product manager in the toolbox area, and they was like, ain't never been an issue. We'll check into it, and we'll see what we can get done. So, okay, great. And I told Clay that. I said, the guy said there ain't never been an issue. They'll check into it and see what they can do. And later on, when I talked back with him, he's like, yeah, we will eventually get a piece of trim to go over that to help cover that, but it's nothing on our radar doing right now.
Like, they drug their feet. Yeah, so, I mean, it wasn't nothing.
I passed the word along. I mean, it wasn't nothing to do with me. I mean, I didn't build it.
Because I know when we looked at it on the toolbox configurator, there was no gap.
Yeah,
like, it was seamless, you know. So, oh, well. Anywho.
Yeah, even on my route, like, dang, I bet that ticked you off. I was like, man, don't bother me. I got paid, so I ain't worried about it. Yeah. You know?
He actually probably made more money selling it twice.
Yeah. Yes, I mean, I don't hold grudges and stuff. I mean, I never got mad at Clay. I never said, I mean, Clay asked me. I was like, do it, dude.
I know everybody's like, I bet Hamilton got pissed when he walked in and saying, I said, nope. He walked in there. I showed it to him. I explained the whole thing, you know, and he's like, that's a nice looking box.
Yeah.
I mean, it is what it is. Like, everybody wants you to hate that. I went with another brand, and I'm sure you'd rather see a Snap-on brand in there, but
everybody doesn't understand,
at the end of the day, like, me and you are friends. You know?
Yeah.
Just because I like a Matco ratchet, you're not, like, throwing rocks at me when you pull it.
I don't care. I sold plenty of Snap-on ratchets out here. So.
I probably own more Snap-on ratchets on your route than anybody, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah. So. I'm not like a lot of folks. I ain't getting mad over it. I mean, it ain't worth that to me to get mad over
and
it.
And if Snap-on comes out with the regular ones with the 100th anniversary heads, just the regular.
Oh, yeah, any of them.
I'll be getting some
instead
of them.
Instead of the Snap-on USA, put the 100th anniversary or just the 100th symbol on there.
Yeah. Well, I bought that 3-pack just because of that.
It's still in there on the table in the package.
And it'll always be in the package.
Yeah, which that's what you said when you bought it. He's like, I don't know why I'm buying it. Well, because I wanted it. But I'm never going to open it.
Yeah. Oh, well. I like them.
Yeah.
It's weird. It's some days, like, hey, I want to use my old, like, that real long 3/8 snap-on ratchet that I got. Like, I really like that ratchet. I use that ratchet probably more than any other snap-on ratchet that I have. And then that little quarter inch that you put the 3/8 head in it, I use it a good bit. And
like these.
Yep. You know, those are my two that I use a lot. And there's some days I'm like, yeah, I kind of want to use my half-inch snap-on ratchet, you know?
So. That's like these right here.
Everybody's got
I try to keep multiple on the half inch.
Yeah, that's a tough son of a bitch right there.
Yeah. Like,
if you guys are looking for a half-inch drive ratchet that's tough as, like, all get out, that's a tough ratchet right there.
And just so everybody knows, the part number, I'm sure we get text messages, SHLX80A.
Like, course, that's the one, if I have doubts, it's going to come loose. That's the one that I grab.
Yeah.
Because, honestly, and I mean, I'm telling you this, and you're my dealer, that's my breaker bar. Yeah. I own a breaker bar, but that's technically the one that I use for a breaker bar.
Well, I had a breaker bar in my own box, and it was this one right here.
Yeah, that's the same one I got, except I got just the soft grip version.
Yeah. Just, mine was just like this, hard grip and all. But I put it on the truck and sold it because I did have the half inch like this, straight, without the lock and flex head and everything. And I still got that, but now I got one of these in my toolbox. And if I got to have something for a breaker bar, then some of this.
Them's tough, but man.
Don't say just because I got this, I'm going to use this bad boy, because if I can get that electric on there, then I'm going to put that electric on
That's
there.
That's what
I ain't going to lie about it. You know?
If I can get an impact on it, I'm putting an impact. And I'm not going to lie about this. And I may break the head off of it tomorrow, but my snap-on electric ratchet is tough.
Yeah,
like I don't know how I've not broke the battery out of it, because I will put out on that bad boy and they take it.
Grab
like, I don't
right
know what
there.
The rated foot pounds of them are, but like I've had it enough that it I was like, yep, she's fixing to break.
Well, they like, of course, this one's 70, this is the brute, the other ones was 40, but I think the head torque, Snap-on said at one time that like they rated them, I can't remember if it was like 150 or 200 manual foot-pounds. I could look it up and tell you exactly.
I guarantee you I have come extremely close to the maximum capacity that that ratchet can handle at times.
Yeah.
Because like the battery's popping.
See if it shows it on this one or not.
What you done got up here? Another set of wrenches? Ratchet wrenches.
Yeah, that was these was a trade in. The fella bought them, and he probably bought these from me shortly after I got started. I mean, you could tell. I mean, he'd used them, but not just no whole bunch. And it he wanted to trade them in. He said that he thought he could use the space in his box with other stuff more than he could these. And
if he'd have bought the reversible.
Well, he had the reversible, and he bought them first, and then he bought these later just because it was straight. Mm-hmm. Hey, sometimes you just got to have a straight one, but after 3 years,
that's where
I
should have bought the long ones.
The long straight ones.
Yeah.
And he had them too, and I think that's where he used more.
Yeah.
And they was the rationing ones too, when you got to buy both sets to get one set, because they...
They smart. Where they're marking them.
It says 158 foot-pounds of manual torque. With the head hold.
Yeah.
I know that I've seen videos where they was taking a long neck when they first come out on the torque testers, and they was getting over 200. I seen one guy had like 255 all they could pull on his. Mm-hmm. He's braver than I was, because I don't think I'd want to try to pull them 255 on there.
Yeah. I know they're tough, man. Of course, I have to give it to them.
But you on a car, you don't pull with everything you got if you got to.
Yep. But I'm the same way. If I can stick something with a battery on it, get it loose, that's what I'm going to do. And then, if it don't want to cooperate, I get that big half inch, and usually one or two things will happen. I'll smile or be like, start cussing.
Yeah, then going for that extractor set.
That's the two options you have at that point. Like, you're either grinning or you're cussing.
Yeah.
So. Yep. Well, what new and exciting stuff we got this week? Did you get
now, the only thing really putting on here this week was the jackets, which I think I already showed them on here a couple weeks ago, but I finally put them on here, and some pullovers and stuff.
Yeah, everybody was asking for the part number. Like, they don't have numbers on the bag.
I mean, I could look up a part number, but it's, I mean, they're not going to be able to look it up by that, though.
Yeah, I think the dealers, two different regions have different codes.
Yep.
And this year, I think we talked about that last time.
Yeah, because like last year, ours was gray and black, which ours has always either been black or gray and black. And the year before, I got in there was brown. But like the central, like Texas and all that, I think last year had like the red and gray, which, yeah, the red and gray looked good. I mean, that was neat. But now, looking back, I'm glad we didn't have that because they get a lot of dirt, or you'd see a lot more dirt on it with the black stuff we covered up.
Well, I know the coats that y'all had last year is probably one of the best looking coats that they've ever had.
Yeah.
Like, because them were really, really good looking. Like, when I wear it out, people say, man, that's a good looking coat.
You know
it's a good looking coat. And the one I got the year before that, when I bought the blue bottom box, that's probably the best rain jacket I own.
Yeah.
That one, like, I use it more that, for a rain jacket than I do a warm jacket.
That wasn't the Carhartt material. When that was the year.
It was like the black nylon.
Yep.
With the,
year before that American was the Carhartt material and stuff. Yeah.
Like, I like that coat.
Yeah.
A lot.
Yeah, these are a lot thinner. And I actually just like the one that I've been wearing for 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
But. Well, I went with we had the option this year. This should have been the first year we could get the thick or the thin. Well, every year I've been in, we only had thick coats.
Yeah.
I've ordered the thin ones this time.
That's what I liked about the ones last year. They're not too heavy, but
they thinned them down a little bit from the year, because the year before that was heavy.
Yeah.
And then, I went with the thin ones this year, which I mean, they've been a big hit because I ain't got a whole lot of them left.
That's good.
Yeah.
So, you got something new and cool up here.
Yeah, this is a new socket that they just released. Similar to the wing nut sockets, which I think a lot of folks have used the wing nut sockets, and I got one of them too, right here.
Let's see that one, show it to.
This is quarter inch drive, and I asked why are they quarter inch drive when we first got them. I didn't know what they was used for. I thought it was another wing nut socket, but it's a Powerstroke radiator drain socket. That's when you put this up in there, you only got room for the head of a 3/8.
Yeah.
Where it
it's
is.
It's tight in there.
Yes, like I said, you only got room for the head of the quarter. That's why the socket is not much smaller than the ratchet itself.
Ain't that something? So there you go.
RDS F1.
So there you go, Powerstroke guys.
Yep.
Boom. Perfect. Awesome new tool.
That's it.
Sure enough. Well, I guess we're going to get in here and see what we can get into inside the shop and wrap it up. Thank God it's Friday.
Thank God it's Friday.
Ready for the weekend.
It's been a long week this week.
You going hunting this weekend?
My son, he's been hunting every day. Every single day he's been out there in the woods hunting. Then, I'll probably go in the morning for a little bit with him just because I ain't hunted with him all week. But otherwise, I'll be working on the house tomorrow out tonight. My daughter got a basketball game we got to go to. All the way down there in Amory, Mississippi. You can't even get there from here.
Yeah, dude. Just go the waterway.
Yeah.
Turn right.
Put my boat in it, Fulton, and float down there.
That's it. All right, guys. Well, y'all have a good week. Hopefully, y'all have a great weekend. And like always, thanks for watching. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up. Merchandise, cool tools, and discount codes in the description. If you're not subscribed, it don't cost you nothing.
Might as well do it.
It ain't like a snap-on payment.
That's
right. It's totally free. You just take your finger and you press that button. That's all it takes. And you're in. All right, guys. Have a great week. Catch you next time. See ya.